Dalgety Bay used to have a World War II maintenance aircraft base, and they decommissioned it, mothballed it after the war.
In the 1990s, some radiation monitoring, just in support of environmental monitoring for a nearby nuclear site, discovered some contamination on the beach, which turned out to be radium contamination, which is thought to originate from luminized dials that were used on aircraft in the Second World War and were disposed of, but maybe not disposed of as well as they could have been. Since then, there's been surface monitoring, so sort of very reactive, not proactive. So when they found something, they've picked it up and they've removed it. But a decision has been taken recently that rather than just keep doing that, the best thing would be to completely try and remediate the site. So we're looking for radium contamination in quite a lot of beach material that's being excavated and passed for monitoring. If nothing was done, there's the small risk that people who access this beach area could get a slight radiation dose from the material, and that dose could potentially exceed the public dose limits for radiation protection. And then with that, as radiation dose increases, so did the potential risk to health. So what we've got here is we've got a number of sodium iodide detectors, so they're very sensitive gamma detectors, they're 3-inch detectors. So we've got 8 of them in series. Each of them is looking at a defined volume of material. So the way it works is the material is presented to the detectors. There is a very short scan taken of the material. And then we have a spreadsheet tool, an operator station over here, and that alerts them if there's been a detection. In the case of a detection, what they will do is they will then use one of these handheld instruments, and they will use that to monitor around and locate the source of that particle. And then they will remove that with a trowel. If we have detected something, we then need to detect a much smaller particle, so we do a much longer scan, and we're looking to see if there's any other material, any other contamination before this volume of material is deemed to meet the detection criteria and it's suitable for return to the beach. I've got a picture of myself when I'd set up the 4 detector system, and I think I almost felt like it's not my children, but it's something that I've put together, I've tested, I've developed, and it works and it's meeting the objectives. So I feel really a lot of satisfaction from that.
I think the thing that Jacobs brings to the project is that we've got a really diverse mix of skills. So we've got radiometrics people, we've got radiation protection advisors, we've got physics modelling capability, so we also, as part of the initial calibration, we did some theoretical modelling using Monte Carlo techniques to actually predict what a detector would see when it was looking at material in a certain geometry. So we've got that capability, and we've also got operatives that have got years and years of site experience of going to different sites, dealing with different problems and controlling those safely. So it was really the fact that we've got a multidisciplinary team and we can do that all in-house.
Growing up in the area as a boy, and that would have been around this coast probably when I was about 7 or 8, 9, like playing and that. So that sort of hits home a bit as well, but and passing it on to future generations like my daughter.
I think it will be satisfying. It's very, it's quite different. It's a publicly accessed site. It's not on a nuclear licence site, so it's something that's, maybe a bit more real to, to a lot of people.
You can see around you what the difference it's going to make to people. And to have the opportunity to work on a site like that and a job like that is a bit different and a bit special. So I think what we're doing is going to make things better for the local community.